The house is packed to the rafters for a San Francisco treat. The PBA Bowlers Tour makes its way to the Bay Area, and they better plan on throwing strikes if they want to earn the first Silicon Valley Open Championship. It's live next on ESPN.
Serra Bowl in Daly City, California, not far from Candlestick Park, not far from the Embarcadero, the Transamerica Tower. The PBA back in the Bay Area for the first time in 8 years in a big, big way. Welcome to the inaugural Silicon Valley Open. You know, by the early part of the week, the San Francisco papers were saying the tickets were going fast. By Friday morning, the joint was jumping. We've got a sellout crowd. Along with PBA Hall of Famer Marshall Hohmanhagen, everybody, and welcome. You know, you look at the sellout crowd, the diverse crowd, if you will, and it takes me back to the old Oakland Coliseum, the days of the great left-hander Kenny Stabler when he lit up the scoreboard. Speaking of left-handers, four of our five finalists here this morning, Marshall, are lefties, and that's a little bit unusual.
Well, it is, Jim, but the reason we have more lefties this week is because the left side, certainly there are less left-handers playing on that side. It stays more consistent. But aside from that, the carries seem to be better from the left side right from the get-go. Now, we do have one right-hander on, and if he can make it through that first match, his length should get better with each and every game.
Our top two seeds this morning, both are left-handers. One is a former PBA Rookie of the Year. The other is a little bit unhappy. His Colts are not in the playoffs, but he expects a big day here this morning.
Well, Mike Aulby is a second-seeded player and PBA Hall of Famer, 26-time PBA champion, and in my mind, the most opportunistic player in the history of the game. You give him a chance to cut you at the end of the game, and he's going to strike out and win. Now, our leader, Jason Couch, the fireballer from Florida, high backswing. You'll see the pins flying back and forth. He really makes them dance. It's going to be a great show.
Well, let's meet our five finalists here at the Silicon Valley Open.
In fifth place, the only right-hander to make the finals from Andover, Kansas, Justin Hromek. Fourth seed and looking for his first PBA title, Chris Hayden. A California native and four-time winner on the PBA Tour, Dennis Horan Jr., qualified in third place. The second seed in search of his 27th title from Indianapolis, Mike Aulby. And our tournament leader, Jason Couch, the first and only player to win back-to-back Tournament of Champions titles. That's our field for the finals of the Silicon Valley Open. Marshall, thoughts today on lane conditions?
Well, the lanes are the synthetic surface. Now, the oil is 33 feet, it's buffed down to 43, a double Christmas tree pattern, and it's wide going forward and a little skinnier coming back. Should provide some very, very good scoring conditions.
In our first match, the number 5 seed from Andover, Kansas, Justin Hromek, will face our number 4 seed from Tampa, Florida, Chris Hayden.
And not too unusual, Marshall. Each had a 300 game in the match play qualifying.
Well, the qualifying scores were high, the match play scores were high, and I certainly look for that to be a trend today. It's a bit of a distraction for Hromek as someone dropped a glass. And he leaves the 10-pin, and I alluded to that in the opening, that the carry, what I mean by carry is the corner pins are tougher to knock down for the right-handers than they were for the lefties. But, boy, what a great run Hromek made last night to make it to the telecast.
The 99 and 2000 Steve Nagy Sportsmanship Award winner right here. And the easy convert in frame one.
Our first look at Hayden as he leaves the 2-pin. Very soft through the shot. We'll take a look. You'll see how very easy with the fingers through the impact zone. Timing wasn't quite right. Didn't get up there with good leverage, and Ball did not hook up to the pocket.
Yeah. 30 years of age out of Tampa, Florida, speaking of football in the host city for the Super Bowl. Fifth year as a pro.
Hayden using a ball that has a very strong drill, 3 3/8 inches from the axis, a big hole drilled in the side of it to be more aggressive, help his ball get up to the pocket.
Well, the aggression pays off. Who's the most aggressive bowler you ever bowled against?
Well, that'd probably be Mark Roth. We had many great battles back in the 70s and 80s, and he was scary.
There you go.
Wow, ball coming in light. Very fortunate he trips out the two pin. He'll take that. That'll loosen you up a little bit too, Jim.
Won his very first title as a touring pro, the senior doubles, with his partner Dick Weber back in 92. Justin did. What's the yellow tape there in the index finger?
Well, it's a grip, and it's used to keep the pressure off his index finger. It gets kind of sore. Well, he takes advantage of that great break in the second frame with a pocket strike in the third. Great release at the bottom of the swing. Ball over around the 10 board, coming back into the pocket. That's a little more like
two in a row for the ex-All-American out of Wichita State there. Not Chris.
And he leaves a soft seven. Six pin staying in the channel. Not able to kick out the seven. You'll see it, the second from the left. That's the four pin. Not able to knock out the seven pin. Throw the ball hard and straight for the conversion.
You know, as you and I sat and watched the qualifying yesterday, you made an interesting point. You said in the finals today with the left-handers actually become right-handers today. Explain.
Absolutely right. The advantage of having that side all to themselves has been negated. With four lefties and one right-hander, it could be advantage to Justin Hromek.
Well, we said the PBA is back in the Bay Area for the first time in 8 years in a big, big way. We're live at the Serra Bowl, and it's the inaugural Silicon Valley Open. We're live on ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. A sellout and enthusiastic crowd here at the Serra Bowl. Actually opened up back in the 60s, built on what was a produce farm. This great bowling center.
Well, right now, Justin Hromek trying to produce another strike on 14. He came in light, left the 10 pin on his first delivery on 14, then tripped the 2 pin. He must keep his speed down in order to let the ball drive back into the pocket on 14. Comes in light again, shakes them out, just slow enough to allow the ball to turn back into the pocket. And a great reaction from the pins. Watch the head pin. It's going to do the damage. Scatters them all over the place.
Third strike in a row.
He likes it.
Mentioned that award that he won back-to-back in 99 and 2000. Early wake-up call this morning. Said he got up about 5:30.
Just does knock out the 7-pin. What a great shot. Ball coming back into the pocket.
Watch the seven. It's going to stand and just gets nudged out. Oh, look what I did. To cut into the lead, Hayden working on a strike. Solid six and a very nice shot from Hayden. Just creeping up a little bit high.
And frustration. Spare strike, and a spare coming up.
Yeah, just unable to put them together right now. And I really feel like he, coming into this game, he had to feel that he had the advantage. The lefties were really dominating throughout the whole tournament. Now, advantage has turned over to Romick's side.
Hear the crowd say, hurry, hurry. They weren't sure it was going to get there. Neither was Chris. The first tennis Grand Slam of the year, the Australian Open, moves into its second week, and the ESPN networks are there to bring you all the action. Tonight at 9:30 Eastern Time on ESPN2. Tomorrow afternoon at 1 o'clock on ESPN. Early round coverage continues on the worldwide leader in sports, the Australian Open. Down by 30.
On the lane he was comfortable on, an errant shot, ball hooks early, and it's the four and the seven. Fortunate to break down the split.
You know, you're a golfer. We talk about a golfer's routine a lot, and all these guys enjoy golf as well. How important to the bowlers is routine? I mean, they were here until 6, 7 o'clock last night bowling, and then some did practice, and now everybody had a 5:30 wake-up call.
Well, it's very difficult because the bowlers are used to having a little more sleep, a little more time to get ready, so they have to adjust it.
Five in a row.
Hromek on fire right now. Great pin action. Ball driving past the nine pin, but it's taken care of, and he knows that's exactly where he wants it. That's the solid shot. Hromek using a ball with a pin 5 inches from his axis point. It's been sanded with 600 grit, and that helps him read the mid lane a little better. Gets the ball hooking sooner, so it doesn't go down too long. Well, there's an opening, the four, the six, and the nine.
All right, give us a little clinic here.
Well, he cut that ball short. What I mean by cutting it short is he didn't get the... Watch as he didn't get the ball out far enough onto the lane, hooked it early. The ball drives so much through the heart of the lanes.
And this is a split you don't see all that often.
No, you don't see that very often at all. He takes the nine pins, and he's still got a very good advantage, but he's given Hayden a chance to come back.
Justin Hromek, a 27-pin lead. Welcome back live to Silicon Valley Open here at the Serra Bowl on ESPN, along with PBA Hall of Famer Marshall Homan. Hope you're enjoying the action this Sunday morning on the West Coast, early afternoon back east.
Now, Hayden, a chance to come back. Hromek opened up the door with that split in the seventh frame. This man's got to step through the door.
Open the door a crack, and he puts it through.
And you could see as he threw that ball, he liked the way the ball was rolling down the lane. You could see his mannerisms.
The great Earl Anthony was Chris Hayden's idol. Had a chance to bowl with him back in the World Team Challenge, back six in Baltimore. Imagine a lot of young bowlers had Mr. Anthony as their idol.
Well, if they're left-handed and they didn't, I'm not sure who they were thinking about. Quick. Leaves the one and the three, six and the seven. Get the ball left, right side. Well, he got it to the right side of the head pin, but he didn't get enough of it to drive it into the seven. You'll see him overcutting the head pin, not able to get into the seven. Open frame and...
That open door closed quickly.
Yeah, it shut.
Slammed. 39 pin. Lead for Hromek. Whoa! I believe Dennis Horan, the third seed after match play qualifying, knows who he's going to play.
Watch the head pin go to the sideboard. It's going to come back and do the damage on the 10 pin.
Ooh.
Politely knocking it down, and oh, look what I did. Now that'll lock things up for Justin Hromek. The best Hayden can shoot is 206. Five right now, shooting at a 230 pace.
Five in a row for Justin, then open in the seventh.
Sometimes it just feels so easy. There'll be other days for Chris Hayden. Talented young lefty. Got to be disappointed. You know, it's so difficult to make it to the telecast, Jim. And when you get there, you want to maximize your opportunities.
Mentioned, it's his fifth year for Chris as a pro. Four PBA regional titles.
Finishing like a pro, striking in the 10th frame. See some of the amateurs that bowled in the tournament this week, and Jerry Kennedy had a very, very good finish. He averaged 222 this week, actually did a little better than his league average. Other players struggled. Much more difficult on the pro tour than bowling in league with your friends, and good experience for the amateurs, the local players.
195 as Chris Hayden finishes up. And from shoot cam, we've got a champion. Five in a row, the seventh open. A strike. And Hromek will advance here at the Silicon Valley Open. Next up, we'll come back and meet his opponent, Dennis Horan. Back live at the Serra Bowl. That's been home to the PBA and the PBA seniors throughout the years. We go down and check the score in match number one. Justin Hromek advances. The Tampa, Florida native Chris Hayden dispatched by that 255 to 195 march. And we go down with Marshall Holman.
Thank you very much, Jim. I'm here with Jason Couch, the tournament leader. And Jason, you've got a great record as a tournament leader. What goes through your mind? Your 6 out of 8 wins for number one seed.
Well, I think Parker Bones said it best. He said, when you lead a tournament, you've shown everybody else for 48 games out on the bowling center that you're the best that week. Now go show everybody on TV that you're the best out there today.
Okay, and you've made a couple of adjustments in your game as well. It looks like you've toned down your revs just a little bit. How did that come about?
Well, my coach down in Sebring, Florida, Richard Shockley at the Kegel Training Center, he told me that I could get a little more versatile if I could slow my rev rate down, going from 440 RPMs down to about 350 now. And it's made a big improvement in my game.
Okay, now, there are 4 lefties, 3 left, and 1 right-hander. Normally, the lanes are all to yourself. You get the fresh lanes. Not today, Hromek has it. You see a little edge for him right now.
I think they're going to start to transition for him a little bit under the lights today, but I'm going to think like a right-hander today. I'm going to chase the oil line as much as I have to stay on top of it.
Okay, Jason, good luck to you. Looks like he's ready to win. Back up to you.
Thank you, Marshall. Jason, of course, the number one qualifier after action here at the Serra Bowl. Resides in Claremont, Florida. Mike Aulby, the number two seed. You'll see him a little bit later on out of Indianapolis. And now the man from Temecula, California, Dennis Horan, up against the fifth seed, Justin Hromek. So the right-hander with a chance to plow through 4 lefties.
Solid 9. Great delivery down the lane, but watch as the ball drives through the pocket, right past the nine pin. The balls are so strong.
Pretty impressive in the first match. He had those five strikes in a row, then left one open. 10 strikes in total.
And that'll get it done most of the time.
Just the one open as you look at the success factor today. Kind of interesting listening to Jason said he's going to think like a right-hander. Kind of embellish that for us.
Well, he throws the ball like a right-hander. I mean, he's got that high backswing. It's very, very powerful. Justin for the... for the spare. They said, in thinking like a right-hander, he wants to chase the oil. Which, what he means by chasing the oil is he's going to keep moving into to the right side of the lane because the oil will dissipate as the more left-handed balls are thrown down the left-hand side.
Dennis Horan has won the Bear Brunswick Touring Players Championship back in 98 and in 2000. And a good start for the man that won the first ever arena final in Erie, Pennsylvania. Beat Brian Boss a couple of years ago. Pretty impressive record, too, as the top seed.
Very, very solid player and much more experienced than Hayden. Should give Hromek all he can handle. Comes in high, leaves the 6 and the 10. Breaks down the split. Look at his form. Shoulder high backswing. The head stays very, very erect through the impact zone. He's trying to push the ball over to the left so it doesn't come in high, but it does come in high. Keeps that head up because he likes to spot way down the lane.
Looked like a place kicker that knew the kick was wide of the uprights. Then he tried to...
Yeah, you know, once that ball's off your hand, all the motion, all the body English, all the prayers can do much good.
You can almost see on the delivery there, I mean, excellent pace, good tempo, found the groove early in his first match and hasn't lost it.
Well, he's comfortable, Jim, and you're absolutely right. A good observation. That's what the players are looking for, to find the line on the lane where they can just get themselves in a much more comfortable position. They know they've got a little room to the right, a little room to the left. A break for Justin Hromek, the 8 and the 10, the last two pins to fall.
Is that ball going fast or slow as you look at the way the pins are dispensed?
Well, the pins fell awfully slow, but that's got moderate speed on the ball. But as I said earlier, he's got to be careful. If he gets a little too fast, the ball accelerates down the lane, doesn't hook back enough.
Well, he was down by 10, but not very long. Dennis Horan, strike, spare, strike.
He's handling lane 14, needs to figure out how to get lane 13. Came in high last time on it. The high flush shot on lane 14. Horan's using a urethane cover stock with a pin 4 inches from his axis. There's no weight hole in this ball. Gives him a very smooth reaction, very predictable. Oh, boy. The 3, the 7, and the 9. So often when you come in high on a certain lane, you come back to that lane, you'll over-adjust, and he comes in light. He leaves a virtually impossible spare.
Percentage of conversion on this split would be?
I'd say he's got no chance to make this. Just needs to get the two pins on the right-hand side.
If he were right-handed, he'd have a shot.
He'd have a slim shot at it. Yeah, very, very difficult. And when a player leaves a split like that, he knows he's got virtually no chance to make it. Just take your count. Don't put yourself in too big a hole. And virtually the same thing for Justin Hromek as Dennis Horan left. It's the 2, the 4, and the 10. Now, this can be made because he doesn't have that sleeper pin. He's got the pin, the 2 and the 4.
Well, and the good news is he's a right-hander.
Yeah, well, the good news is he does have a chance to make this. He needs to get his ball to the left-hand side of the 2 pin and drive it into the 10. Overcut it.
Well, from bowling to hoops, plenty of college action on the schedule later today on ESPN2. First, the New Mexico State Aggies take on the South Alabama Jaguars, a Sun Belt Conference matchup, 5 o'clock Eastern time, followed by a Conference USA tilt between the Cardinals of Louisville and the Southern Miss Golden Eagles. College basketball on ESPN2. For more, log on to ESPN.com.
Much better control of his speed. It really is so speed sensitive. And as the lanes do break down, even though there's just one right-hander bowling out there, Justin has to continue to move a little bit left. And sometimes if you move left a little too much, Jim, you hit too much the lane oil, ball comes in light. Educated guessing going on both sides of the lane.
Wow. After a strike, a spare, a strike, and open. Leaves another split on lane 14.
And it appeared to me that Horan just decelerated on that shot, didn't get the good projection down the lane.
As a bowler, do you know when you deaccelerate after it leaves your hand after the release?
You know it immediately. As soon as that ball is off your hand, you know whether you have a good chance to make a strike or not. This is also another makeable split. Got a little too much of the two pin. Well, it's close, but close is not going to get it done here.
When you leave two open in a row, how big a hole have you dug?
Well, he had momentum on his side after Hromek opened in the fourth frame, and then he came right back and threw another open, so he throws his momentum away. Have to put it behind him. And on a shot that would normally strike, the 10-pin doesn't fall. Usually the light hit is very, very predictable on these pins with the strong bowling balls, generally getting strikes.
That's mom on the left, Terry, and daughter Courtney. I wonder what time Courtney had to get up.
Everyone's up early this morning. He makes the spare.
She's happy. Way to go, Dad. Let's go. We're rooting for you. We're live on ESPN. Come back with us to the Serra Bowl just outside San Francisco. Justin Hromek plowed through match number one. He's got a lead here in the second against Dennis Horan. But don't forget, man from Indianapolis, Mike Aulby, waits, as does the former PBA Rookie of the Year, Jason Couch.
Two big, powerful guns. Looking forward to bowling either Hromek or Horan.
I was having coffee with Justin this morning back in the locker room and kidding him. I said, there's no room for any more logos.
Ball coming in light.
He said, yep, I'm starting to look like a race driver.
Look like race car drivers out there. They got something on the left arm, something on the right. Look of confusion on Romick's face. Just when I thought that Hromek was looking comfortable on the lanes, there's some doubts creeping in.
When you're bowling, as you have in your Hall of Fame career, and those doubts start to creep in, how do you chase those demons away?
Well, you have to try and just clear your mind. You know, I contend that you always do your best work when you don't think about any kind of the outside influences. Don't think about the bad shot you may have just thrown. Put yourself in the present and look to the future. Oil is carrying down. You hear Hromek commenting about how having trouble getting the ball to hook. The oil carries down the lane as the ball comes in light. 8-pin will be the last one to go, which makes for a relatively easy spare conversion. And he makes it. Well, Horan, who's thrown two opens in a row, and working right now at a 170 pace, certainly has an opportunity to jump right back into this match. Justin leaving lots of room.
That's how he won four PBA national titles in his 16th year.
Nice shot of the release. Fingers coming right up the back of the ball and a great follow through, which is really a good tip for anybody, but whether you be right-handed or left-handed. This is the lane he has not struck on yet. He must finish on this lane. So this is the lane he must have liked, yet to strike. There it is. Now he's tightened this match up.
You know, I know you guys are a little bit superstitious, right lane, left lane. He has no superstition.
Well, you don't have to have any superstitions when your ball carries like this. Just splits the pins apart. Finally, I get a strike in that lane.
And a post-strike prayer. Not Justin. That was pretty sporty, because if you look at that again, he looked a little bit off at release. His balance didn't look quite right, did it?
Well, he got his center of gravity a little bit off to the right on the release, but was able, you can see he's going to fall off just a bit. But he got the good fingers in the ball, good direction down lane. Great reaction. Leads by five pins. If he doesn't strike in the ninth frame, Horan can get up and shut him out. Got to hurry. Oh, and it did. Great shot of Hromek. Straight backswing. Coming right at you. Made a couple of adjustments. They certainly paid off. Moved in. Slowed the speed down.
Yes, sir. That's three in a row. Well, less than a month remains to cast your vote for one of seven players. To participate in the battle at Little Creek, click on to the news section of the PBA website, pba.com, and make your selection. And while you're at it, check out all the latest news and information on the PBA Tour. All that and much more at pba.com.
You know, you could even vote for a guy named, Holman. That's right. Just a thought.
That'd be a dimpled Chad.
Flight again on lane 13. It's the 3 and the 9 pin. And watch the look on Horan after he releases the ball. He knows he didn't catch the fingers. Ball's not going to come back. What are you going to do? All in the release. Well, he makes the spare. The best that Horan can shoot is 195. That still forces this man, Justin Hromek, to get up and mark in the 10th frame.
Tell you what, we've got an interesting storyline developing. Four of the five finalists were left-handers, and so far, Justin looks like he's going to get rid of two of them.
Well, he needs to perform in the 10th frame, but certainly in control of his own destiny. And I'll tell you what, right now, Jim, I always fantasized about being the only right-hander on a telecast with four lefties. Never happened in my career. Had that side all to himself. Once again, any kind of a mark. Just the 10 pin. You'll see a little different approach to this shot. He's going to throw the ball hard and straight, just needs a spare, and then a three count. The three count, that's a given. The 10 pin, he should make this 95% of the time, if not more.
If he misses this, he'll drive back to Andover, Kansas.
Well, he's flying. He makes it. Right now, Hromek's job is to concentrate on this fill ball. All he needs is three pins, but what he's thinking about is the next match. I want to get myself lined in, get myself prepared for PBA Hall of Famer Mike Aulby.
Two wins in a row live on ESPN this Sunday morning here in the city by the bay from Indianapolis. Mike Aulby will be up next. Well, what Andre Agassi did for tennis apparel, Danny Weissman is trying to do for the PBA. Danny and his interesting attire when we come back. Five strikes in his first match, dispensing with Chris Hayden. And there you see the score as Justin Hromek advances, downing Dennis Horan. Mike Aulby will be up next here at the Silicon Valley Open, where the tour goes, the PBA Tour, the next couple of weeks. They'll be at the Las Vegas Open in the city of glitter and gold next Sunday, 2 o'clock Eastern Time, right here on ESPN. Then we'll be in my hometown, Toledo, Ohio, the PBA National Championship, February the 4th. The Winter Tour continues at the Parker Bone Empire State Open in Latham, New York, not far from Albany and Sarasota. Danny Weissman hails from Baltimore. He, of course, will root for the Ravens in the upcoming Super Bowl, but his bowling attire, well, at times looks more like some of the Ravens. Let's find out why. Weissman is one bowler on tour that has taken to heart the concept that the PBA is changing in a fashion sense. Danny's moving forward by taking a step back to the future.
They're throwing it around in my mind. How can I incorporate this into the bowling scene? And knowing that there's a market there for it, and I wanted to be different. And I've always been a little different through my career in certain aspects of it. And I wear these clothes normally when I go out, and I just thought it would work. And it definitely separates me, and I like, you know, the fact that it is different and looks good, I think.
Danny's, well, sort of different look each week has definitely opened up some eyes. He dares to be different. So what's behind his taste in clothes these days?
To a little bit of the Danny Weissman individuality here. First of all, we got the black and orange, and I thought that would kind of look nice together, so I'm going to go with it. When I'm feeling a little bit more conservative, we'll go with the classic black and white 50s look with the, of course, red pants to just enhance the shirt a little more. And of course, when it's one of those days and I'm just feeling a little fired up, we're going to pull out the flames. And we're going to just absolutely destroy the pins. Along with that, we got the leather pants, which just enhances the whole look. So I kind of like this stuff, and it's kind of all about me when it comes to the attire, being a little different.
He dares to be different. It was interesting, the crowd reaction when he pointed to the leather pants. Got a chuckle here at the Serra Bowl. And actually, Justin Hromek was watching that feature up on the Jumbotron as well. From Andover, Kansas, the right-hander, the only right-hander left in the field of five. He's beaten two lefties. Next up, Mike Aulby from Indianapolis. Match three. Sellout crowd. We're live at the Serra Bowl. They sold this out early in the week. They tried to sell some more tickets. Their folks were lined up early this morning.
Well, we're all kind of cramped up in this beautiful bowling facility, having a great time. And I'll tell you right now, normally, after winning two games, the opposition might be a little bit leery of his chances. But Hromek did not dominate in the last match. He just barely squeaked through. Aulby, the opportunistic, seasoned pro, looked great in practice.
Showing the form why just last week Mike became the third player in the history of the PBA to go over $2 million in career earnings. Is being the only right-hander an advantage?
Well, yeah, it certainly has been for Hromek. He can...
Well, you can add one more strike to the success factor today for Justin Hromek.
Well, through two matches, he has 16 strikes. He's made all his single pins. He's
Had a couple of splits, hasn't made either one of them. Those are the two opens. But getting back to the advantage of being the own right-hander, he knows that his ball is the only ball on the right-hand side that's carrying the oil down and changing the lane pattern. So it makes it easier for him to adjust to his own carry down. Ooh. 7-pin standing for just a second. It falls down, but the 10-pin doesn't.
Is Hromek Irish? A little luck?
Well, he was fortunate right here. You see that 7 just toppling at the last minute. Made the 10-pin in the 10th frame of the last game to win. And he makes the 10-pin here.
Otherwise, he might have been 0 for 3 on split.
If that 7-pin doesn't fall, you can book it. He wasn't going to make the 7-10, although it's been made a few times, but not very often.
26 PBA national titles for this man.
And he just drilled this right lane in practice. Kind of like that, Jim. Nothing fancy about Mike Aulby. Very basic in his form. Doesn't put a lot of big, heavy roll on the ball, but has great direction and has a super mental game. Just the ability to focus on the task at hand. Mike Aulby, as good as anybody.
How about consistency? I mean, the PBA Player of the Year in 85, and then 10 years later in 95. That's a model of consistency.
Well, it is, and he's gone, went through a lot of changes with the equipment and the lanes, the pins change. He made the right adjustments and still a top bowler today. Ooh, ball hooking in just a skosh high. Leaves the 6 and the 10. Thought he had it. He was running it out like he thought he was going to get it. Ball over the 7 board. Coming back in. Just leaving what we call the fast 8. Might have had that ball set just a little bit early. Didn't get the proper loft down the lane.
Two strikes and a spare. Good shot of the release.
Up the back of the ball. Very important. People think that the ball hooks because you put spin on it. It hooks because of the forward revolutions. And that better hurry up. Look at that ball come back.
Strike in the first, a spare in the second. And the third, all 10.
Well, this ball I thought was going to hang. He got good leverage coming back from the 3 board. Watch the 6 pin. Bang! Just knocks the 10 pin out. 8 pin lead for Mike Aulby. Hromek can cut that lead to a plus 2 if he strikes here. For the lead. He's got it.
Talk about in the zone.
And Mike Aulby using a ball with an aggressive cover stock. He's got it sanded with 600 grit to create more roll.
Well, I mentioned that just last week he was the third player in the history of the PBA to go over the $2 million mark. Ray Williams Jr. and Pete Weber, of course. Parker's closing in.
Oh, he'll get there soon. He's a machine.
He'll sell that many books. Now, Mike.
Well, he's got the right touch to just kick out that 7-pin. Very soft with the fingers at the bottom of the swing. Lets the ball roll. Doesn't force anything. Watch the 4-pin. It does the damage on the 7. The reaction? Oh, yes.
Big week for this man's son, CJ, back in Indianapolis. CJ plays on the squirt hockey team, kind of a farm team of the Indianapolis WHA Racers. And CJ won all 3 games this week. Had a couple of assists, so proud dad right there.
Well, big hockey fans, the Aulbys. And bowling fans as well. There's another strike for Aulby. He extends that lead. Now back to 8 pins. Now, can this man answer?
Does the pressure build as you're trying to plow your way through and win four matches in a row?
Well, I think there's a different kind of pressure on Hromek in this game because he's bowling 26-time champion Aulby.
ESPN Classic brings you the all-new Game of the Week tonight at 9 o'clock Eastern Time, where you can relive one of the greatest games in NFL history with the comments of the men who played the game. Joe Montana to Dwight Clark, you remember it. They called it the catch when the 49ers met the Cowboys in the NFC Championship game back in 1981. That's tonight at 9 o'clock Eastern Time on ESPN Classic. Not far from the Serra Bowl. It was Candlestick Park that day. And I actually did that game on CBS Radio.
I was watching. I'm a big 49er fan, born in the Bay Area, and those were some fun years. Hromek, two pins in the lead, can extend to 12. The two, the 8 and the 10. No leverage on that shot. Ball squirts off his hand. He'll just take the count, go for the 2 and the 8 pin. If you get a lucky bounce and you make it, well, so be it, but probably not going to happen.
So as Marshall said, you just take the count. We'll take the count and go to commercial, then come back live. It's the inaugural Silicon Valley Open on ESPN. Mike Aulby trying to stop the momentum of Justin Hromek. Mike actually made an equipment change this year, and you thought it was very significant.
Well, it was significant. He changed ball companies, and now he's a free agent. He can throw anybody's equipment. It takes a while to understand exactly how to set up your equipment to optimize your chances. Seven pin won't fall. You know, he was used to throwing one company for years and years and years. He knew when one ball wouldn't work, he'd switch to another. Now, as a free agent, he has the ability to throw, you know, anybody's equipment, and it can be kind of confusing. Hard and straight, no problem.
One of the things you like about Mike's game is his mental edge.
Oh, it's superb. It's as good as anybody. Maybe, you know, Norm Duke would be comparable, but certainly not any better than this man.
Hey, come in!
Now, Mike doesn't always get the job done, but he never makes the mistake with his mental game. Solid push away, straight arm swing. Watch the four pin, it drives out the 7.
Justin now down by 12. Got it a little high and got plenty of pin action.
Now the ball did cut through the pocket just a tad. It didn't touch the 9 pin, but some other pins got in the way of that and knocked it down.
The winner gets the number 1 seed, former PBA Rookie of the Year Jason Couch. Right now, it's anybody's game.
Well, it is, and Hromek down by 12 pins to this man, Mike Aulby. He can cut that to a 2-pin deficit with a strike here in the 8th frame.
35, 35!
And a great adjustment. And actually, not so much an adjustment, Jim, but just a better shot on lane 13. Last time on 13, got quick, got the ball to the right, never did make the corner, left at 3, the 2-8-10.
Max score for Mike, 257. Justin, 3 strikes in a row, the 6th open, then 2 in a row. What a reaction. He was halfway to the 101 expressway.
He was coaxing that ball back up to the pocket. Come on, baby. Come on. You can do it. It did. 12 pins down. Justin Hromek.
kind of the time of the match where you don't look at your opponent?
Well, you know, there's nothing to be gained by watching Mike bowl right now for Justin. He's not going to learn anything. He bowls on the left-hand side of the lane. Hromek's on the right.
Come in, Bob.
He's praising himself. Good shot, good shot. You're right, Mike. Great shot, great shot. He really hangs on in the follow-through, holds it. And right now, he's just watching and enjoying. Oh, yeah. Dead, solid, ninth frame, perfect.
Down by 22. Justin?
Must have it. Got to hurry. Crawls up to the pocket, knocks the 6-pin out. It looks as if Justin has started spinning the ball more. You know, he was working on keeping his hand behind the ball longer. He has a tendency to come over the top of the ball and spin it, does Justin Hromek. 245. Best score that Hromek can shoot.
See, Mike's not looking either.
What a great classic battle between Justin Hromek and Mike Aulby. Hromek moving further to the left, slow rolling it. Bang, right in the pocket. All right.
Made a change in his delivery earlier this year, right?
Yeah, the change was that he tries not to initiate the turn until later in the downswing. That keeps him further behind the ball, more solid forward roll. Oh, yeah. He'll be in the 240s, and he'll force Aulby to have to strike.
That's five in a row for Justin.
Very important that he fills 10 on this shot. 245 would force Aulby to strike, nine spare, to win by a pin.
Six in a row. What a spectacular finish. Looking for his fourth PBA title. Strike nine spare now is what Mike needs, right?
That's what he needs. And I said it early, when he has a chance to get the job done, he walks right through the door. Can he do it again?
Justin never looked up. His head never wavered.
Nothing he could do right now. That was the tough part, getting that first strike. Nine spare. I know Aulby will nine spare. I just know it.
So does Justin.
Oh, I'm sure Justin feels like this match is over. I mean, stranger things have been known to happen, but that is Mike Aulby.
If it's an eight spare, guess what? We've got a tie.
Yep. Then they'd have to go into a sudden death, one-shot roll-offs. Just needs to stay in the pocket. He did his job. He's a professional. He got nine. Put the ball in the pocket. Needs to make the spare. He knows that he's going to make it.
There's some nervous folks back in Indianapolis. Mike's wife, Tammy, son, CJ, watching this morning.
For the win. Count it up. Mike Aulby. He'll be in the final match. What a pro.
What a terrific match. Justin Hromek had a terrific Sunday morning here at the Serra Bowl. He plowed through lefties Chris Hayden and Dennis Horan. So the championship match, the second seed, Mike Aulby up against Jason Couch when we come back live just outside the city by the bay. Boy, did we go bowling here, and what a terrific match with Justin Hromek and Mike Aulby. And while we were away, something that you seldom see at a bowling center anywhere. Justin got a standing ovation, and it was like the Giants and the Ravens getting ready to come out and kick it off. They were chanting, Justin, Justin. I mean, that was a great match.
Well, it was a wonderful match. That's why the people tune in to watch Pro Bowlers Tour. Great matches like that. 246, 245. Now let's take a look at some of the other finishers here this week. As you can see, Brian Smith from Winchester, Oregon, finished ninth, had a good week, just unable to really turn on the charge towards the end of match play. And Norm Duke, the player of the year from last year. 11th spot for Norm. Danny Wiseman, the man with all those different clothes, who says it's all about him. Well, this week, it's 15th place for you, Danny.
I want to see you try some of those leather pants.
I don't think so.
Well, it doesn't get much better than we saw just a few seconds ago. Hromek up against Mike Aulby. Now the championship match.
And these are the two players who dominated throughout the week. Never bowled each other on television, which...
That's kind of unusual.
Well, for as long as they've been on tour, it is very unusual. Now that's not unusual. Mike Aulby throwing another strike. Now, first look at Jason Couch. He's throwing a ball with a 4.5-inch pin with a small hole as he takes a re-rack. He's got a lot of surface on this ball. He's going to make the ball hook a little earlier. He can move in on the oil more to the right. You like that power ball?
It was that power exhale when he got rid of all that oxygen before rolling the first one.
He was a little nervous before the start of this. Ball driving back strong. The four pin just enough to bounce the seven pin out.
Thank you. Got you.
That's right. I got you.
When you talk about his power, sixth in the PBA world power rankings, Jason is.
Well, that shows his consistency throughout the last couple of years, but the power that he puts on the ball, the revolutions that he imparts, are frightening. And he's actually toned it down a little bit. Solid eight. Ball driving right past the eight pin and a wry smile from... Well, they love you. They love you, Jason, but the eight pin doesn't love you as the ball drives right past it.
When he talked to you, he told you that he liked his chances as the top seed. How come?
Well, he takes the momentum from qualifying in match play as he converts to the eight pin. He takes that momentum and uses that to inspire him to greatness during the telecast.
And in his match against Hromek, there is Mike's success factor again today. And a strike in the first in this championship match against Couch.
Leaves the light seven pin. And that does a lot to keep the hopes of Jason Couch alive. You know, you just don't want to sit there and watch your opposition go up there and go bang, 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 and all of a sudden you're down by 20 pins. Aulby converts another seven pin.
Mike, one of only four men to capture the PBA triple crown. Not too many guys have been Rookie of the Year and Player of the Year, but Mike has.
Well, it just shows that he came out on tour and he was a fine player and he's just continued through the years.
Come up, Bob. Come up, come up!
22 is the PBA star. Of course, the Silicon Valley Open has been sanctioned by the American Bowling Congress, providing championship services and programs to bowlers since back in 1895, when Marshall had his mustache.
And make sure you bowl in a sanctioned league.
Nah, Jason.
That ball, errant shot. He turns his thumb down. When he accelerates too fast from his backswing, he has a tendency to turn the thumb down, gets the ball rolling early, never gets far enough to the left, and goes right through the heart. That's a mistake that he works to try and minimize. It creeps in every once in a while.
Do bowlers, after they have a match on television, look at a videotape? Do they check their form? Do they look at the tapes?
Absolutely.
And what do they learn?
Oh, chops the spare. Two pin right off the four and the seven. And you can learn a lot by watching yourself on other telecasts. You can see what you did in key situations to win. You can look at your mannerisms, check to see if your intensity was too high at any one particular point. Boy, and it's just a big error for Couch as he opens down by 15.
That kind of form earned Jason Couch the first player in the history of the PBA to win back-to-back T of C titles. Re-rack for Mike.
Players look at the one and the two pin on the left-hand side. That's the pocket they're looking at. They're allowed to have one re-rack.
Some players are re-racks. Superstitious about re-racking, aren't they?
Well, some players won't take them at all. If I'm correct myself, you are allowed to have two re-racks. Aulby not superstitious, he's just good. He's got his speed dialed in right now, Jim. He loves to soft stroke it. Soft stroke the ball down the lane. Let the ball do the work. He's not forcing, that's a good tip for bowling. It's a good tip for most any game that you try and play. And if you force it, you're not going to get the great reactions that you're looking for.
Up by 25 pins now, Mike is.
Stop. 7 pin. Almost. Pin was leaning on it, but not able to make it fall. Mike told me earlier that he was, watch his push away. He wants to make sure he pushes a little bit to the left in order to keep his arm straight through the zone. Get the feeling he can probably make that about 100 times in a row.
So Jason now with some work to be done after leaving the third open.
Now Jason with a couple of strikes can cut that deficit from 24 pins down to 4. Just concentrating on making a good shot. Execution.
Oh, that better strike. Strike.
He knows.
Come on.
Well, get used to that outfit, because if he makes the finals on TV next week in Las Vegas, you'll see it again. That's what he does, superstitious-wise.
He knew that ball was headed right solid in the pocket as soon as it went off his hand. And you talked about that earlier. Do they know if it's a good or a bad shot? Well, Mr. Couch certainly showed us right there that he knows exactly when he's thrown it well.
Made some adjustments during the break, didn't he?
Well, he did. He's actually, as strong as he throws the ball, he's actually cut back on the amount of revolutions.
Make it a turkey!
Oh. That same mistake, once again, leaves the 2, the 4, and the 6. Thumb goes down. Ball hooks early. This can be made. Needs to put the ball the left-hand side of the two pin, drive it over into the 6.
Oh, baby,
oh. Oh, thank you very much. We've got a great championship match. The top 2 seeds, Jason Couch and Mike Aulby. It's the finals of the inaugural Silicon Valley Open, live on the worldwide leader in sports. A dandy championship match here at the Serra Bowl, the inaugural Silicon Valley Open. There is Rex Gulovic, the proprietor of the Serra Bowl. His family's been in the bowling business for 64 years. They've got some bowling centers in Seattle and Kansas City. They've hosted the seniors and the PBA here at the Serra Bowl. Now, Mike.
Aulby just taking care of business, and Couch getting ready to get up on lane 14 after this next shot from Aulby.
Mike's actually a bowling center owner in his own right. 32 lanes back in Lafayette, Indiana.
Just purchased the center a couple of years ago.
Calls it the Arrowhead Bowl. Well, he loves hockey, and his son CJ is a squirt in a league back there. And guess who CJ's idol is? Patrick Waugh. Tonight on ESPN, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, National Hockey Night, the Pond at Anaheim. The Mighty Duck at home taking on the Avalanche. Colorado beat the San Jose Sharks not far from the Serra Bowl, 2-1 last night. Joe Sakic, much in the mode of CJ, had a goal. Avalanche and the Ducks on ESPN, National Hockey Night, 8 o'clock Eastern. Whoa! Well, he said during the break when he talked to his ball rep, he had to be more aggressive.
Well, actually, what he was saying was that he's got to be careful not to be too aggressive. If he gets a little too much fingers in the ball's coming in high. He knows if he throws the ball to the left, it will come back. Couch taking his last re-rack and throwing the most important shot of the week. Really needs to dig into that lead that Albee's built. He's down by 27. A strike here would make it 17 and keep him well in the match.
Come here, come here.
Now the good news for Couch is that he's got everything figured out. He knows exactly what he needs to do. The pins and the reaction from Jason Couch. Unfortunately for Couch, what he can't do anything about is this man's ability to throw strikes. And he's got the lead.
Will it?
Whoa!
Look at that.
Very, very fortunate. Mike Aulby watching his ball, hooking into the 1-2 pocket. It's a six pin. Oh, well, I can make the six pin. Well, wait a minute, maybe I don't have to.
That really loud cheer you just heard, that went up at the Arrowhead Center back in Lafayette. They've got the TV sets on there pulling for the owner.
Well, what a surprise for Aulby. Did not expect that to carry. He'll take it and try and build on it here in the ninth frame.
That would be four in a row.
Aulby working in the 230 range right now as we take another look. You think Aulby doesn't know what to do? He's really found it, and he knows that shot is the one that could very well win him his 27th PBA title. The max for Couch, 232. Needs to strike 9th, 10th, 11th just to force Aulby to mark.
Got the first one.
He's not giving up. I'm sure that Couch realizes even if he strikes it out, it probably won't be enough, but he's got that glimmer of a possibility. Maybe it would be. 232 with three strikes. Must project the ball out to the left. Let the lane bring the ball back to the pocket.
You better carry.
Well, that'll do it.
Hall of Fame? Not in the Hall of Fame.
Mike was elected back in 1996. But you kind of get the feeling that that man, the 92 PBA Rookie of the Year, is headed to the Hall of Fame.
Yeah, they'll find a spot for him. They'll make a spot for him in the years to come. He'll earn it.
What a morning we've enjoyed, though, at the Serra Bowl. And that match between Mike Aulby and Justin Hromek was just terrific by a single pin. Good championship match. Jason headed to Las Vegas next week. As the PBA Winter Tour rolls on, ESPN.
As I'm sure Mike Aulby is as well. about what might have been. Preparing the approach for Mr. Aulby, are you, Jason? Just needs to stay behind the line. Don't do anything silly. And there you go. There's your champion. And what a great champion.
The left-hander from Indianapolis. His 27th PBA title here at the inaugural Silicon Valley Open. Winner, no winner.
Well, we talked about the sellout crowd here, the standing room only crowd at this inaugural Silicon Valley Open, and a man with a big smile on his face, as you check the scores right there, is the man with the Arrowhead Center Bowling Center back in Lafayette. I said there are a lot of TV sets watching and pulling for you. And when you gave it all that body English on that one shot about the eighth frame, I think all those folks were pulling for you.
Well, that's one of the reasons why I do so well, and that's because all the people are behind me at home and all around the country. And we're fortunate to get out there and make some good shots this week and get back in a winner's circle. Boy, it feels great.
How does it feel when you've got a sellout crowd and the crowd gets behind you the way you sensed here this morning?
Well, they were behind me, but I'll tell you what, Justin put on a great show, and they really appreciated what he did. And we appreciate what Sarah Bull has done and all the people that come out today, and that's what makes you get into it and get out there and do well.
All right, we'll see you in Vegas. All right, keep it going. Congratulations to our champion here at the inaugural Silicon Valley Open. A sellout crowd, the man from Indianapolis, the hockey fan, his son CJ back there pulling for him. Join us next Sunday at a special time, 2 o'clock Eastern Time, for the Orleans Casino Open from Las Vegas. Coming up next, the Billiards 2000 Women's Tournament of Champions. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more information, log on to ESPN.com.